talking about resort businesses. Welcome back to Shop Talk. From Boracay, we head to Bohol as we talk about Amorita Resorts. And here with us is our sales director, Rowena Esteban. Hi, Rowena. Welcome
Hi.
To the show.
Hello.
Okay, tell me about Amorita. How and when did it start?
It started during summer of 2007 when the Ria, the owner, spent their vacation and they saw this property in Bohol, and they feel it's so romantic because it's different, because it's in a cliff, and they fell in love with the property and pegged it as a honeymoon destination for them.
Right, so they saw it and they
yes,
said, we want it and we want to build a resort
and
here.
Luckily, it was for sale, so they bought it.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Okay. So, like you said, the resort is different because it's located on a cliff
mm-hmm.
and it's not beachfront,
mm-hmm.
right? So, you get I guess you have a really great view of the
yes,
beach.
Yes, it's very breathtaking. It's 180 degrees of the overlooking the Bohol Sea, and it's very accessible to Alana Beach.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
So, again, it's one of those resorts where you have your own. You feel like your own, you have your isolation, but at the
yeah.
same time, you're not very far from
mm-hmm.
where all the action is.
Yes, it is.
Right. Okay. Aside from that, what would you say makes Amorita different from other resorts in the area?
For Amorita, it's a very romantic, and the ambiance, usually we do cater for honeymooners because it's a very romantic. In the cliff, usually they do proposals, intimate weddings. And what makes Amorita is the service, the personalized service that we cater to the client.
Okay, how many rooms and suites do you have?
We have a total of 36 rooms, 20 deluxe room and 14 villas. Villas are very, very nice because it's very suitable for honeymooners where they have their own plunge pool.
Oh,
yes,
okay. All right. And then the other rooms are located like in a regular...
Regular
like a
room.
Building.
Just
it's not a
building.
A separate
yes, it is.
Thing. Right. Okay. And how would you describe the Amorita experience, whether you go there as a honeymoon or with your family or with your barkada?
Yes, at first it's going to be... It's the first thinking of the client that it's for honeymooners, but we also cater for families. And corporate events also. Corporate events, meeting and conferences.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Considering the fact that it's not on the beachfront,
mm-hmm.
how is the access to Alana Beach? Do you take a trike, a jeep? Do you take a walk or go downstairs?
No, it's just a step going down,
oh,
going
okay.
to Alana Beach.
All right, so
yes.
you can take a few steps down
mm-hmm.
and you're already there.
Yes.
Right, okay. What kind of food do you serve at the resort?
We offer Filipino food, but we specialize right now with Boholana cuisine and Luya degustacion, which
okay.
is what we're offering right now.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of fresh seafood from the
yes.
area,
right now,
I
regarding
imagine.
The seafood, we just launched our Saturday buffet grill every Saturday. So they'll be experiencing fresh seafood. And it is at the cliff. We're having it at the cliff.
Oh, very
yes,
nice. Yeah. Again, something that's very romantic.
Yes, it is.
Right. Mm-hmm. You did mention that there's proposals and intimate weddings.
Yes.
What are the other types of special requests you've gotten at the resort?
Special requests is like surprises.
Mm-hmm.
Surprises like before the clients go in or check in. We have... special request that they have a surprise for birthdays, like there's a special setup for romantic setup, especially the villas. We have special setups like petals, candlelight dinner.
Right, which your staff is very experienced
yes,
at already, I'm sure, right?
Mm-hmm, yes.
Okay, and what are the other activities they can do if they want, if they don't want to just lounge around the pool or the beach? What do you offer?
Yes, Amorita and our Bohol is very well known for the tour, which is the man-made forest, the countryside tour. We also have the Beyond Bohol tour, which we focus on the historical churches, landmarks, and we also have diving. And in-room spa services.
Yeah, there's actually a lot to see in Bohol aside from the beach. Obviously, you
mm-hmm.
have the chocolate hills and you get to see the tarsiers.
Tarsier.
But it does have some of the oldest, most well-preserved churches in the country,
yes,
right?
Yes, it is, yeah.
Right.
Handicrafts also. Handicrafts.
Oh, okay. Like what kinds of handicrafts?
Handicrafts, jewelries, and goodies that is known for Bohol.
Okay. Who would you say is the target market for Amorita? Is it mostly locals and foreigners? And like what segment?
But right now, it's more of Asian. we're approximately around 70 to 80%, but we're targeting European market also, because they usually stay for a long duration.
Yeah, they come a long way, so so they stay a long time. Mm-hmm. As a resort, how do you stay competitive in the market? Again, Bohol is another area or beach where there are just so many resorts.
Mm-hmm. For us, it's a very challenging one for us, but we usually give the best service, the concern, genuine concern to all clients and their needs, and excellent housekeeping for the guests to be satisfied.
Right. Would you say that your level of management and hospitality is at par with, say, resorts that are managed by an international name?
Mm-hmm. We have good reviews, as you could see at the TripAdvisor, so you could check on that, because all of it has a good reviews regarding the rooms, the services, the food that we offer.
Right. Yeah. TripAdvisor is actually a really good resource. I do.
Yes. I do. You could check the TripAdvisor.
Yes, and it's always the actual guest who reviews it. So you know, you can expect something from there. Okay. And let's talk about the rooms, the regular rooms and the villas. What's included in each of those exactly?
The deluxe room, as you can see, has two separate queen size beds that can accommodate a maximum of 4 persons. It's a more of a building type for the deluxe room, but much more of a higher category are the villas, which is much more different from the deluxe, which has a king size bed and their own plunge pool, a very romantic ambiance for the couple or family.
Right. Okay. And the decor that's used, is that the like Asian or Filipino?
It's a Filipino. It's being fully furnished by a well-known furniture designer from Cebu.
Oh, yes. Okay. I think I know who you're talking about.
Yes.
Okay. And what are the rates, the range of rates for the rooms to the villas?
For the villas, it's a range. It depends on the seasonality.
Also.
Yes, it would depend on seasonality. But right now, we're on the peak season. That's and we
right.
also offer packages that the different groups can enjoy.
Right. Okay. And are you fully booked already for the Holy Week?
Yes, we are.
Darn.
Yes.
Okay. Aside from summer, is there another time of year that you're also booked up? I guess maybe around Christmas?
Yes, we always have activities in the resort, like seasonal activities like Valentine, Christmas, usually long weekend. Usually that's the time that the resort is very, very peak. And also
right.
Christmas season.
Yeah, the break
yes.
in between Christmas to yes. to New Year,
New
I imagine,
Year,
is
yes.
always full.
Mm-hmm.
Right. What are activities to do there for kids?
For kids, we have cookie decorating, and that's it. We have some cookie decorating for them.
Yeah, and I'm sure the beach and the pool keeps them
yes, the infinity
busy
pool
enough.
Is very well known for Amorita.
Right, okay. And what are your future plans for the resort? Will you be introducing anything new this summer or within this year?
Yes, there will be a plan of expansion soon, but you know, people watch out for it, because there will be a good offering and amenities that Amorita could offer.
Wonderful.
Yes.
That's great. So please invite everyone to the resort.
Yeah, so hope to see you. Hope to see you in Amorita. And you will really enjoy and visit our website for all the things that you'll be needing for the packages that we'll be offering for 3 days and 2 nights.
All right, mm-hmm. sounds good. I could use mm-hmm. 3 days and 2 nights
yes,
at the beach.
Yes, because it would not be okay if it's going to be an overnight stay.
Definitely,
yeah.
definitely. Thank you so much
you.
For Shop Talking with us, Rowena.
Thank you so much.
And thank you for watching Shop Talk. I'm Ria Tanjuatco-Trillo. Follow ANC Shop Talk on Twitter and be a fan of ANC Shop Talk on Facebook. Join us again tomorrow. Enjoy the rest of your day.